I'm ready.
Are you ready, kids?
Aye, aye, Captain.
And 30-year-olds?
I can't hear you.
Aye, aye, Captain.
This weekend, part of Hollywood is transforming into an underwater city people have known and loved for 20 years. The Bikini Bottom Experience opens today, and no one was happier to get a sneak peek than the barnacle heads of the Five Live team. Are you a goofy goober?
I'm a goofy goober, yeah.
I'm a goofy goober, yeah.
We're all goofy goobers.
Yeah, we're all goofy.
And Sam is our queen. Queen of all goofy goobers.
Oh my God. Today is the best day ever. The Bikini Bottom Experience is celebrating 20 years of SpongeBob SquarePants. For 3 days only on Selma Avenue in Hollywood, guppies and arthropods alike have a chance to go to Bikini Bottom. It's so realistic, it'll blow your mind. Wake up like SpongeBob. Get a job at the Krusty Krab. Live like Patrick under a rock. And as a SpongeBob super fan, I totally geeked out. And you can probably tell, talking to these very important Bikini Bottom best buddies. I am a 30-something-year-old woman, and I am living the best day of my life today. I'm here with Tom and Bill, Patrick and SpongeBob. SpongeBob and Patrick.
I'm Patrick.
You're SpongeBob.
Oh my gosh.
That's Samantha. Mom. Sam.
You guys, how do you keep 30-year-olds still in love with the show they've watched since the pilot episode many years ago?
Let's be honest, Sam, you're pretty easily entertained.
How did he know that so quickly?
I know you.
It is amazing that the footprint and the longevity that this show has been able to enjoy. We always say it's like we found a lottery scratcher on the street and rubbed it off, and it still paying off, you know.
There's some weird alchemy at work here with the colors and the shapes and the sounds. I don't know.
I imagine the first table read was, were you thinking you'd be here on the 20th anniversary?
Wow, no. And we were just hoping that the show would get picked up for a series, you know, that it'd go a season or two. And then there actually was a wrap party after the first three or four seasons.
After season three.
Well, that was a good run.
We were canceled,
And then by then, suddenly, the network started to realize,
the first movie, too.
Momentum of this show, it was unstoppable. Like, holy cow, we really got a tiger by the tail here. And it's amazing.
I was going to say, I have a lot more journalistic questions to ask you, but the first would have to be, are you a goofy goober?
I'm a goofy goober, yeah.
I'm a goofy goober, yeah.
We're all goofy goobers.
Yeah, we're all goofy.
And Sam is our queen. Queen of all goofy goobers.
Oh my God. I am the Kevin.
Yeah.
Where's the pickles?
Oh my God.
Because it sounds like radio voice.
Yes.
from the Chase Bank Auditorium in Chicago. This is, wait, don't tell me. Oh, this is everything.
Just go in there in your house and just think. This is my thinking helmet.
How do you guys feel about being the core of meme culture right now?
It's amazing. It's new ones keep coming out, and I'm just amazed by the creativity of the people that make them, whoever they are. Like, I always picture maybe there's like one guy somewhere.
That's
you
a
know
great image. Yeah.
Yeah.
Slaving away
in the meme factory. You know,
sees the sun.
Chained to a wheel somewhere. More memes.
One of the things that makes me appreciate that meme culture is knowing how Steven Hillenburg, the creator of the show, enjoyed that kind of dynamic of people enjoying and celebrating it in their own way. And he did. He really loved that.
Steve liked DIY stuff. And when somebody would make their own
do-it-yourself
thing, like when they, he would see somebody that had made like a Goofy Goober sailor cap with the peanut on the stick on top of it. He thought that just made him happy way more than official merchandise. When he would see a manifestation of SpongeBob that somebody was just
organic
moved to make an organic.
Very validating, I'm sure.
Yes, and you know, the memes are funny because you know, SpongeBob has been...
These are absurd.
What's interesting about the memes is that SpongeBob is kind of the last big pre meme pre-internet culture thing that's still around. Like SpongeBob predates, you know, predates internet culture, and it's amazing.
It's true.
So I think
we don't predate The Simpsons. Yeah, that's about it.
No, exactly. Yeah, The Simpsons has got a bunch of years on us. Hopefully we'll be able to go their distance. But it is just incredible that. You know, SpongeBob started before any of that was a thing, and the people now making the memes are, you know, they're just kids that grew up with SpongeBob, and they have this encyclopedic knowledge of, like, the drawings and the faces and what exact pose.
That is very true.
Yeah, what exact pose will
encapsulate
a moment or a feeling. Girl come up to me at the Grove last night.
Oh, no.
All right, this is funny. She goes, could you do the SpongeBob voice? And I go, yeah, it's the best day ever. And she goes, I meant the season one voice.
Oh, what a dig.
Like, I need you to walk away right now.
We have to do a reenactment of that. We have to cast someone as the elk. Oh, that is wonderful.
Is that, were you just kind of like, oh, that's not very funny?
No. So I said, no, so I just did a line from the first episode. Today's the big day, Gary. You know, where his voice was a little lower.
Did she accept that?
She did. She said, thank you.
Phew.
She goes, thank you.
So unsatisfied. Yeah, that'll do.
I was like, I feel like I deeply disappointed a human being.
Oh, no. Okay, so I know our time is almost running out, but there are two more things. First question of the two. What do you share with your character personality-wise?
Well, I have a great regard and respect for my friends.
Oh, how's that's that? A sweet answer. Yeah.
Thank you. And, you know, I pretty much wear my jellyfishing goggles all the time. And I think Steve saw various aspects of our characters in us. That's why he cast us. You know, I'm hyperactive and I work hard and I jump around and scream and stuff. And
Eternal optimist, maybe?
Eternal optimist or trying, you know. SpongeBob has actually made me more optimistic. Like, playing him has brought me over to that side even more.
I think it has. That's
and,
right.
It
That's
has. Right. And just to survive, man, you have to in the world.
Uh-huh.
And Bill, I would say, being a couple of IQ points smarter than Patrick, also, there is some Patrick-ness in you, too.
Sweet, caring.
Yeah.
Spider! You don't want to be a spider in my house.
Yeah, physically, you know, very, very dynamic.
Thanks, you guys, for being such great sports.
Thanks,
super happy about it.
Really fun.
All right.
You've been planning your whole life.
Oh, my gosh.
That is just a few blocks away. Can you believe Bikini Bottom was always there? A few blocks away.
If I had known. So you'll get to see the second question in the next hour.
Yes.
I asked him two more questions before we left, and truly one of the best days ever.
Yeah.
I was so truly filled with joy.
It was really fun. What a cool thing that was.
Also, just to mention, it's on Selma Avenue today through the 20th. Tickets are available now in standby. I think pre-sale is already sold out, but you can actually go down, get in line, wait. There's a retail store, and as you're walking into the little memorabilia, it says 20 years later, and that's so great, so wonderful, thought of every detail. And I did get my driver's license.
Yes, you got not one, but two, because you didn't like the first one.
It's Mrs. Puff's boating school is not like the DMV. They did let me retake
that's
the picture.
That's true, they did. This is mine. Though when you retook your photo, they were like, here's your second one.
Oh, they made it very clear.
They were not happy with it.
Well, I know you guys were flashing your IDs. I don't have mine ready.
You don't have yours ready?
No.
Well, can you get it ready while she shows you which one she ended up with?
So, this is the OG. My name on it, which the camera probably won't pick up, but this is, should I Instagram person it? That is anchovy. I am, I believe, 6 centimeters and I weigh 3 ounces. So my new identity is anchovy. And I believe I live on 96 Coral Lane or something like that in my new identity. So thank you all. I will now be going by
anchovy. Can you see it, Robert?
Chovy.
Anchovy, wow.
Maybe legally but in hopes of having a SpongeBob identity, I'll be going by Anchovy. My other one is Holly Mackerel. I'm 11 inches and I weigh 2 pounds. My eyes are hazel in this one. So I have two identities. One will be my, you know, college fake ID. The other I will actually use at a bar, which I did last night, and the bouncer did not find it very funny.
I thought he was like, also the waiter, remember? He was like, can I see your ID? And both of us all at the same time were like, here you go.
Yeah.
Who are you, Robert?
Let's see, I am, it's fitting for me. Herbert Hermit. And I am 3 ounces.
Herbert Hermit?
Yeah, I'm 3 ounces and like 0.6.
You guys are.
Herbert Hermit.
You guys
anchovy.
Are pretty small. Because I'm Terrence Tuna. And I am a height, I'm 8'8".
No.
And I weigh 1 ton. Wow. Which, if you saw my Instagram, is entirely too much tuna.
Oh, no. No. Thank you guys for going down memory lane with us. The Bikini Bottom Experience, again, is in Hollywood on Selma Avenue until the 20th. So fantastic. Can't wait to post that later. And there is a special treat for the 2 o'clock show. Mm-hmm. Thank you to Tom and Bill for just being so wonderful.
Awesome.
They talked to us afterwards. They wanted to hang out.
Yeah, maybe they're going to come and be on the show. Fingers crossed.
A dream.
They want to, but hopefully Nickelodeon will let them.
Anchovy and Terrence Tuna and Herbert Hermit.
Herbert Hermit.
We'll see you.
We'll be right back
in a second.